You can lucid dream tonight simply by watching your mind. And the weird thing is, this is both the easiest lucid dreaming technique, but also the hardest. Are you confused yet? Well, you just wait for it. It gets even weirder. So today you're going to learn a wild technique, a technique used to induce wake-initiated lucid dreams. It's one of the oldest techniques out there, but also one of the most effective. But techniques are more than just a series of steps. You need to understand why you're doing what you're doing. So let's do that. The hidden gateway. So you've probably noticed those strange hallucinations that sometimes happen as you're falling into sleep. Sounds, visions, sensations. What on earth are they? Well, they're called hypnagogia, and they're one of the most interesting liminal states. And despite being one of the weirdest things that can happen to a human brain, most people just ignore their hypnagogic hallucinations. But they're one of the most accessible ways to enter dreaming directly, even though they're not dreams themselves. And if you can learn to walk the tightrope of hypnagogia, you've just unlocked one of the easiest ways to lucid dream. Hypnagogia. Falling asleep isn't like pressing an on-off button. It's more like a dimmer switch. As your brain drifts into sleep, something called thalamic gating occurs. The thalamus is the part of the brain that deals with sensory input, and as you're drifting off, the thalamus closes its gates to sensory input. But the brain doesn't like a void, and when there's no information coming in, the brain will start generating ideas, images, hallucinations. For most healthy individuals, this is a slow process that mostly goes unnoticed. You'll place your head on the pillow, you'll start to drift into thoughts about what you're going to do tomorrow, and as your conscious mind slowly becomes dulled, the hypnagogic hallucinations will occur. But if you're feeling particularly tired, hypnagogia can happen at almost the instant your head hits the pillow. And while these hallucinations might seem like they're related to dreams, they're actually a completely independent state. So if you're experiencing hypnagogia, it doesn't mean that a dream is about to start. What it really tells you is sleep is very close. Surfing brainwaves. So far, all of this sounds relatively easy. You simply go to sleep, watch your hypnagogia, stay alert, and eventually a dream will form around you. Wouldn't it be lovely if it was that easy? But actually, this is more like surfing brainwaves. It requires a very fine balance. And speaking of brainwaves, that's exactly what's occurring. During this state, your brain is transitioning from alpha waves to theta waves. It's kind of a handover going on in your mind. So as the theta waves increase, your internal imagery starts to ramp up, but your conscious mind starts to dissolve. So what's really happening here is your brain is changing its mode of thinking. You're going from structured, linguistic, logical thought to abstractions. So it's not really that you're losing consciousness, just the shape of consciousness is changing. And it really is like surfing. Most people will overcompensate in one direction or the other when they're trying to maintain their balance. If you lean too much into relaxation, into the theta waves, then you're just going to dissolve. Your consciousness is going to fizzle out. But if you lean too much into awareness and focus, then you break the entire process altogether and just give yourself insomnia. But there's another problem, because even if you get the balance exactly right and you're surfing the waves of the mind perfectly, you're not necessarily going directly into a dream. You might be entering non-REM deep sleep, in which case there's no chance of a lucid dream. Timing matters. You can surf hypnagogia at any point you're falling asleep. The process of drifting off is very similar regardless of which stage of sleep you're heading towards. But if you try this at the beginning of the night, it's almost guaranteed that you're going to enter non-REM deep sleep, so you're definitely not going to get a lucid dream. If you want to make use of hypnagogic surfing, you want to wait until REM is far more likely. So REM tends to ramp up during the latter hours of sleep, generally after about 4 hours of sleeping. So if you want to try this technique, try it either after 4 hours of sleep or during a morning nap. Surfing really is the perfect metaphor for this technique because multiple things need to be kept in mind. First, you need to learn to balance because you can't ride the wave without that balance. But equally, you have to choose the right kind of wave. So timing is just as important as balance. Before we go any further, I need to say a quick thank you to my channel benefactors, the highest level of membership here on the channel. Thank you to Murat Yilmaz, Dave Collier, and Dream Leak. And if you'd like to join them and be mentioned in the next video, hit the join button and choose channel benefactor. The technique. So now you understand the foundations of why this technique works and the important relevant details. So if you've skipped ahead to this point, you're going to need to go back and rewatch that because the steps alone won't get you lucid. So this technique is often called the wild technique, but that actually doesn't make any sense because wild is the result of this technique. I call this either hypnagogic surfing or the hypnagogic gateway technique. Step one, choose the right time. So this technique can only really be used after 4 hours sleep or during a morning nap. And by morning nap, I mean waking up at your usual time, staying awake for 10 to 20 minutes, and then returning to bed. If you don't do this, you have a much lower chance of entering REM. So it's entirely up to you. If you want to, you can set an alarm for after 4 hours, or you can wait for a natural awakening, or you can perform a morning nap. Step two, return to sleep. So this is pretty obvious stuff, but ideally you want to be laying on your back so that you don't fall asleep too rapidly. But close your eyes, relax, take a long deep breath, and then just observe your mind. Don't force, don't try, don't aim for a goal. Simply watch as if you're an independent observer that is unbothered by what occurs. Step three, choose an anchor. So for most people, this is going to be breathing. Simply observe your breathing and use it as a reminder to stay present. Now, this isn't focused. You're not pushing for this. You're just letting your breathing remind you that you're going to maintain that awareness gently as you fall into sleep. And the way to think about this is it's essentially metacognition or self-awareness. You have an intention to not let your consciousness dissolve. So every now and then you want to check back in with yourself. Am I losing the plot? Am I drifting off into the narrative of my mind? If you are, then gently bring yourself back to your breathing, back to observing. And this is really important. This must be subtle. It must be passive. If you're pushing with this, if you're trying to focus too much, then you will be overcompensating the balance, and that will only lead to insomnia. This isn't effective by trying. It's effective by simply being present. Step four, apatheia. Apatheia is a beautiful Greek word. It's where we get the word apathy from, and it's the perfect mindset for this technique. Apatheia basically means not caring about the outcome, not in some negative way, but simply observing without judgment. It's very similar to the Taoist concept of wu wei, effortless action. In practical terms, while you're laying there watching the hypnagogia occur, don't respond, don't get excited, don't interact. Simply passively observe what is occurring. Step five, wait. Maintain that state of wu-wei, of apatheia, and just let whatever is happening happen without any attempt to push or enter or change anything. You are simply observing. Eventually, when your mind is ready, when the mechanics of REM have fully kicked in, the hypnagogia will transform into a fully immersive dream world around you. The dream comes to you. You don't go to the dream. You're simply waiting. It's no different from waiting at a bus stop for the bus to arrive. And of course, when the bus of dreams does arrive and whisks you away into whatever fantastic adventure is awaiting, you'll be there, present, aware, and lucid. And if you've enjoyed this video, you might enjoy one of the videos on the screen right now. I'll see you there.